thankful to be here again today. I'm giving the Word of God out. I am Betty Davis, and I want to reach the whole world for every person that don't know Christ. And this is the greatest gift for me because I have served Him almost 50 years, and I have lived the abundant life. And I know that this works, and nothing else in this life makes a difference. This Word of God is pure as silver, tried in the furnace of the earth, purified 7 times. That is Psalm 12, verse 6. And deity is the living Word. And today, once again, we're going to learn, because you need to know the names of Christ, the names of deity, and this is the 3 primary names of deity: Elohim, El, that means strength, and strong one. I pray for the strength of my youth all these years. And Jehovah is also, Exodus 6:3, is God Almighty. He's all-knowing, ever-present. We're going to learn that maybe today, but we may not get to that. And his name is Adonai. That is Lord. That's our Master. And death, this is the greatest gift in the world, has no power over us as a child of God. We will never die. This is the greatest gift in the world. I am the resurrection and the life. He that followeth me shall not walk in darkness, but shall have the light of life. Let's just see all of these names right now that he says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me. John 14:6. Then he says, I am the light of the world. He that followeth me shall not walk in darkness, but shall have the light of life. And he says, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. And whosoever liveth and believeth in me shall never die. These are the I ams that every person should know. This is all just beginning of all that he is for us. Then he says, I am the good shepherd. The good shepherd giveth his life for the sheep, John 10:11. And these are 1 John 11:25, I am the resurrection and the life. You read the book of John, there's only 21 chapters. There are 7 I ams. And the other that I have that I did not have a copy of is John 10:9. I am the door. By me, if any man enter, he shall be saved. John 15:5, I am the vine, ye are the branches. If you abide in me and I abide in you, the same bringeth forth much fruit. For without me, you can do nothing. Without me, you can do nothing. But he's all powerful. He is love. He that loveth not knoweth not God, for God is love. If you hate someone, you are a murderer. And if you murder someone, in the book of Revelation, chapter 16, God is going to give you the blood of that person to drink. Because we're going to find out he's all-knowing. He knows every thought that we have. Not only does he know the number of the stars and calls them all by name, he knows everything that we do, and every knee is going to bow to him. And he hates sin, but he loves a sinner, and he died to save them. This is what we have in him. And I'm going to give you another prayer today, and this one is 1 Chronicles 29. And I want all of you to remember, these prayers are for every believer, every day. Let's pray. Oh, gracious and dear Heavenly Father, once again we come to the throne of grace to obtain mercy and to find grace to help in time of need. And once again, we thank Thee that even now as we come to the throne of grace, that our grace is multiplied in these last days, and our mercy is multiplied in these last days, and our peace is multiplied in these last days. The God of peace sanctify you wholly, and I pray that your spirit, soul, and body will be preserved blameless until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ, and his love is multiplied. And now, David gave us this prayer about our Lord, our deity. Thine is the greatness and the power and the glory and the victory and the majesty. And all that's in the heaven and the earth is thine, and thou art exalted as head above all. All riches and honor come from thee. And we know that thy word teaches us in verse 14 of 29, First Chronicles, all things come of thee. All things come of thee. This is why we want to worship Thee in spirit and in truth today, and in the beauty of Thy holiness. And we want to offer the sacrifice of praise to Thee continually, the fruit of our lips, giving thanks unto Thee. We're praying for 100-fold today, that each person that is in darkness will be brought out of darkness into light, out of the power of Satan unto Thee. And we're laboring fervently in prayer that we will stand perfect and complete in all the will of God. The Lord rebuke Satan and thank thee for giving us victory. In Christ's name we pray, amen. So once again today, as we give this lesson out, here you have to ask. If you don't ask, you will not receive anything from the Lord. You have not because you ask not. Hitherto have you asked nothing in my name. You don't even pray during the day. These are prayers that the Lord has given me that I pray daily for all believers. And then look what he says. He says, hitherto have you asked nothing in my name. Look at this. This is for every person that's a child of God. But if you're not a child of God, you can't pray because you can't. You don't have the Spirit of God and the Word of God living in you. And ask and you shall receive, that your joy may be full. My life is joy unspeakable and full of glory. All of these things is for you. They're for every person in the world. He loves us all the same. We are all one blood. There is no difference. He loves us. He died for the sins of the whole world. And this is what you have. Look at this. Romans 8:32. He that spared not his own son, but delivered him up for us all. All, every person in the world. He loves the same. And he never changes. That's another thing about him. And this, look at this. But delivered him up for us all. How shall he not with him also freely give us all things? Freely give us all things. So I have to show this each week because this is a faith. This is a beginning of your gifts from God. For by grace are you saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is a gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. And then here's our most important thing. Without faith, it's impossible to please God. For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is the rewarder of them that diligently seek him. He is everything to the whole world. And if you don't know this, you're in darkness. You see, in Acts chapter 26, verse 18, this is why I'm giving you these lessons, to open their eyes and to turn them from darkness to light, and from the power of Satan unto God. The power of Satan unto God. You see, as you study these words, this is, I'm going to give these to you because this is very important in these last days, Revelation chapter 22. Now, he says in this lesson that he is speaking to us individually. He says in verse 6, Revelation 22:6, and he said unto me, these things are faithful and true. And the Lord God of the holy prophets sent his angel to show unto his servants the things which must, listen at this, shortly be done. Verse 7, behold, I come quickly, and blessed is he that keepeth the sayings of this book. You cannot please him without knowing this book and living it. The sayings of the prophecy of this book. Jesus Christ is a spirit of all prophecy. That's another thing you must understand about him, because he is the gift of all prophecy. This is why we need to know the Word of God. It is all about him. Now, this is the last book on prophecy. Revelation is the last book. And then he says in verse 10, and he saith unto me, seal not the sayings of the prophecy of this book, for the time is at hand. It's already here. We know that these are the last days because people are so evil, and there is a great need of the Word of God, because we have today the one world religion, the one world government, and they are not teaching the Son of God deity, the blood of Jesus Christ, his Son. This is why you have to know this book, because once you know this book, this is the only true book in the world. This world has nothing to offer any person. It is just, as I always say, vanity and vexation of spirit. And verse 12, once again, and behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me, to give every man according as his work shall be. Now, this is the last book. You have to know this. And then in 22, verse 13, I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. Verse 14, blessed are they that do his commandments, that they may have right to the tree of life and enter in through the gates of the city. This is the holy city. This is our home. Listen at this. In chapter 21, and I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth were passed away. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard great voice but in of heaven saying, behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he shall dwell with them, and they shall be his people, and God himself shall be with them and be their God. And he shall wipe away all tears from their eyes. There shall be no more death, no more pain, no more sorrow. This is for every believer. And then he says in verse 5, and he that sat upon the throne said, behold, I make all things new. These words are true and faithful. The same thing that I just read in chapter 22. And this is chapter 21. Verse 6, and he said unto me, the beginning and the end, I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. It's all free. And then in verse 7, he that overcometh shall inherit all things. But listen at this, if this is you and you have never received Christ, but the fearful and unbelieving, the abominable and murderers and whoremongers and sorcerers and idolaters and all liars shall have their part in the lake which burneth with fire fire and brimstone. You see why I have tears when I pray? And you don't know Christ as Savior? And He loves you with an everlasting love? And you see, He went to the cross as we saw last week. And now He says, we were not redeemed with corruptible things as silver and gold. Your gold and silver are all going to be left behind. Everything you have is going to be left. The Antichrist is going to be everybody that has rejected Christ. He is going to be their slave. And everything you have will be under His control. You see why we have to know these truths? And we have to obey His word. And these are the things that this teaches us. And this is the truth about worshiping anything but deity. Exodus 20, verse 3, thou shalt have no other gods before me. Matthew 4, 10, thou shalt worship the Lord thy God, and Him only shalt thou serve. And this is so many times in the book of Revelation and all through the book of the New Testament. Everything in there has something for you. All worship apart from the Son of God is idolatry. 1 Corinthians 16, 22. If any man love not the Lord Jesus Christ, let him be accursed. Jeremiah 17, 5. You have to write these down and read them over and over and give them to your friends. Thus saith the Lord, cursed be the man that trusteth in man and maketh flesh his arm, and whosoever heart departeth from the Lord. There's no hope for anyone that is worshiping idols or man. Jeremiah 17, 7, blessed be the man that trusteth in the Lord and whose hope the Lord is. We have nothing else but Him. Once again, in Revelation 19, 13, the word of the Lord, the word of God, the written word, makes known the living word, and it is the word of life. You should sit down right now and begin to read the book of John. And he says, God is revealed through His names. Man's true resource is in God. John 3, 27, a man can receive nothing except it be given to him from heaven. 1 Chronicles 29, 14, that I just gave you. For all things come of thee, and of thine own have we given thee. Psalm 29, verse 4, the voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord is full of majesty. I want to ask every person that's listening, what can you say to someone that loves you that much? You fall on your knees and say, Lord, save me. So he says in Isaiah 45, 18 and 22 both, I am the Lord, and there is none else. He says, remember the former things of old, Isaiah 46, 9 and 10. I am God, and there is none else. I am God, and there is none like me. In His deity, He is acquainted with all eternal purposes. He knows everything we do. The exaltation of Christ is Christ in you, the hope of glory. So we're going to just learn just a few things about what we are as a priest of God and as kings of God. Revelation 1, chapter 1, verse 5 and 6. Unto Him, Christ, that loved us and washed us from our sins in His own blood, and hath made us kings and priests unto God and His Father, to Him be glory and dominion forever and ever. All believers has a kingdom, a priest, a royal priesthood. I want you to listen at what we have that has never been for anyone else. The difference from any priesthood in the Old Testament, except the priesthood of Melchizedek in chapter 7 of Hebrews chapter 2, he is a picture of Christ. Melchizedek in Genesis 14, 18 through 22, you have to read these and understand them. He is a priest, Christ is, after the order of Melchizedek, as King of righteousness and King of peace. And this is in Hebrews. I have to read this to you in Hebrews because this is all about what he is. In Hebrews chapter 7, verse 21, for those priests were made without an oath, but this with an oath by him that he said unto him, the Lord swear and will not repent, thou art a priest after the order of Melchizedek. And this is why we must, in verse 24, but this man, because he continued ever, hath an unchangeable priesthood. Christ never changes. This is what we see, verse 26, for such an high priest became us, this is us, who is holy, harmless, undefiled, separate from sinners. We do not, if any person wants you to sin, they are your enemy. And this is from sinners, who needeth not daily as those high priests to offer up sacrifices, first for his own sins and then for the people. This he did once when he himself offered up. We saw that. He went to heaven to wait on us to be raptured, to be with the Lord, and so shall we ever be with the Lord. He is in heaven praying night and day for every true believer. And here we see in Hebrews, this is so many of them in here that I don't know which ones not to read and which ones to, but I want you to get in here. He says, whether the forerunner is for us entered, even Jesus, made an high priest forever after the order of Melchizedek. And he was prophet in the Old Testament. Today, he's our great high priest. And we are a royal priesthood and kingship, and we are going to be reigning with him 1,000 years in this new Jerusalem that I just told you about. This new Jerusalem, this is where we're going to be. The street is pure gold. The city is pure gold. And here we are in heaven, and we're praying to him. We're praying to him. The first 7 seals, the people are that have not accepted Christ, they cannot be saved after they are in the 7-year tribulation period, if they've heard this. Now they are praying for the rocks and mountains to fall on them, and we're in this beautiful place that he has given to us, and it is a holy city. And all the nations of the world are going to come and worship, and we are going to be there. And this is the greatest gift in the world. And he says the priest in the Old Testament had to come from the tribe of Levi, and the king had to come from Judah. Now listen to this. God had a royal priesthood in the Old Testament, one who was the king of Salem and the priest of the Most High God. Christ is such a priest. Christ is the branch, the living one. He is made a priest and has a priesthood which we are part of. I want you to listen to this. The Lord of hosts is the branch, and now we are made a royal priesthood. Christ has given us both his offices, a royal priesthood and kingship. we're going to be reigning, and listen what we're going to be doing in that great new holy Jerusalem. In the rapture, we shall be called up to be with him, then the marriage supper of the Lamb. Then when he comes back to reign with us, we're going to be reigning with him 1,000 years on this earth. 1,000 years. And I won't get to go into all of this, but listen at this. Do you not know that we shall be, as our believers, this is what he wants every person to know, that we are, I have to give this to you, this is 1 Corinthians 6:2. Do you not know that the saints shall judge the world? That's what we are going to do in serving him. This is the greatest. Nothing in this world is anything that is eternal. But all of these things are eternal. And they are for us. And not only that, but I won't get all this in today, but listen at this. Eternal things begin. God has chosen us to eternal things. All of these things are his. And why are we not worshiping him and giving out his word and teaching people about him? This is the most amazing story in the world. And all of it is just simple. For by grace are you saved through faith, and that not of yourselves. It is a gift of God, not of works, lest any man should boast. But here we are. The Lord himself shall descend from heaven with a shout, with the voice of the archangel, and the trump of God, and the dead in Christ shall rise first. Here you are. Your body is back in dust. And then we which are alive and remain shall be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so shall we ever be with the Lord. When we reach a speed of light, 186,241 miles per second, we're changed in a moment. We're going to receive a body of light that never hurts.